Hello and welcome to 1995batman.com. Today we are looking at this, the Martial Arts Robin Deluxe figure from Kenner. So the Deluxe range was, I think it was about five figures. I think you got three Batmans, one Riddler and one Robin. And they were all kind of like slightly unusual. They were meant to, a lot of them had giant backpacks and stuff. With the Robin figure, for whatever reason, they chose to do a really weird experimentation with by making it super poseable and flexible. Although having said that, it is also very difficult to it's very difficult to stand up, but I've got it stood up, so let's start keep talking about it. So as you can see, they've done this weird kind of like almost like he's wearing kind of like metal armor, but they've kept kind of the legs kind of dark green. And the red kind of tunic. They've got a green mask instead of a black one. The head sculpt is pretty much the same as all the other Robin figures, and he's wearing a black cape, which is just plastic thing, which we can take off. It's probably easier if we take it off, because, as you can see, he is super poseable. So he's got bends in the knees. Whoop. They're a little stiff and a little loose at the same time. It's an odd combination. Bends in the hips as well. The waist turns. There's an action feature, which I'll try and do now, so that when you twist it, he sort of lifts up. It's hard to do in this kind of thing, but as you can see, when he twists, he kind of does like a kicking motion. So this is, yeah, this is not a figure that is very good for standing up at all. He's got bends in the elbows, and then he's on kind of like a little bit of a ball joint on his shoulder. This is interesting, but pretty unsuccessful, I feel, just because you cannot really get it to stand up at all. He also came with a bunch of accessories, martial arts accessories. I am not knowledgeable about what these weapons are. He has kind of like a stick, I guess, with kind of like a little bit of cloth. He also has the classic kind of Kenner kind of blade weapon, giant blade. And then he also has kind of like a shield, and it's got this little clip here, which clips onto his gauntlet here. So if we can just, there we go. So he can sort of, you know, shield himself from attacks. Yeah, what else can I really say about this figure? It's unusual. I'd rather that we had something a little more interesting, but you know, it is what it is. It was Kenner experimenting. Tellingly, they didn't do any kind of poseable figures like this for the Batman and Robin line, so I guess it wasn't really successful. You know, a lot of the other Batman Deluxe figures for this line had kind of light up features. The Deluxe Riddler had like a talking backpack. So this is sort of, yeah, I don't feel like this really gives us a deluxe, you know, the deluxe treatment, as it were. And the black cape, you know, is, I get it, because Kenner, you know, they have to make these kind of cheaply and quickly, and they couldn't do the kind of black on the outside and yellow on the inside. But it would have been nice to have had, you know, an attempt at doing that. Instead, what they did is they had either a black plastic cape or a yellow plastic cape. But yeah, this is okay. I really wouldn't recommend it, though. If you are going to get it, at least get it boxed, because a lot of the loose figures have, just because they're out of the packaging, are literally loose. Their joints are just kind of flopping all over the place. And this kind of like metal, looking kind of silver paint that they've used scratches really, really easily. So yeah, all in all, this is a pretty unessential figure. If you're collecting the Batman Forever toy line, you don't really need this. It's not deluxe, and yeah, it's a miss for me.